for, as a reward for bringing me off of the waiting list, I'm going to give you two talks for the time of one. But don't thank me. Actually, you should thank Carlos Vinueza, because in his performance the other night, where he magically determined two of my cards seemingly as easily as one, he also magically enabled me to have the time to do, or the ability to have two talks in the time of one, and you'll see why. So the first talk is called Stack Exchange Silence, and that's the bonus talk. And so here's a question that I put up on Stack Exchange. If you can't read it, that's okay, because I'll tell you what it is. You see it's got two upvotes and three favorites, but not a single word of feedback. And then I suddenly realized last night, as I was realizing this magical situation, that I'm probably standing in a room where somebody here can tell me the answer off the top of my head. If you can, don't yell it out. Tell me afterwards. Okay, so here's the question. An icosidodecahedron has 30 vertices. See, I counted them, so I know it has 30 vertices. And then it's got a bunch of body diagonals, which are any segment, which both ends with both endpoints are vertices of the icosidodecahedron, but it goes through the body, not along the surface. And the question is simply, are there 15 diagonals on which the symmetries act transitively? That's not an example. I strongly suspect the answer is no, but I don't have a disproof. Okay, end of talk one. Okay, so the second talk is entitled Generating Gengzhi Goblets, and I thought, you know, it'd be nice to go to G4G13, it'd be nice to participate in the giveaway, but I gotta make something for the giveaway, and it's supposed to have something to do with the number 13, so I thought and I thought, and then I realized I only know one thing about the number 13. So this is the only thing I know about 13, so I gotta somehow turn this into a giveaway gift. So I thought, well, this is about adding two things to get something else. What's the most interesting example of adding up two things to get another thing that I can think of off the top of my head? And so hats off to Rod Bogart. I saw this at an earlier Gathering for Gardner that he created. This depends on the principle elucidated by Archimedes that the sum of the volumes of a sphere and a cone gives you the volume of a cylinder. So I thought I should do something that would be an elaboration and a tribute to this lovely device. And so I thought maybe I should look at the proof, and here's where Carlos does his magic, because he told you all about, this is my version of the diagram, but he already told you all about this. And so I don't have to say anything about it other than that note, the area of the two pink circles on the right is the same as the area of the pink circle on the left. And so we use a principle that was first written about by Zhu Gengzhi in about 460 of the Common Era. And so, of course, because he came up with it by Stigler's law, we call it the Cavalieri principle, after Bonaventura Cavalieri, who also happened to write about it over 1,000 years later. But I figure since it was 1,000 years later, we should be down with Stigler, and we should call it the Gengzhi principle. So then the other thing to notice in this proof is there's a lot of flexibility. It doesn't have to be circular cross-sections at all. Oh, sorry, first, the first flexibility is, if we look back here, you can see the volume of the cone goes as h squared, the area of the cross-section goes as h squared, and so the volume of the cross-section of the sphere goes as 1 minus h squared. H squared plus 1 minus h squared is 1, but there's nothing special about h squared. You can use, in the first set there, you can use h instead of h squared, you get a couple of paraboloids. You could use h cubed instead of h squared, you get h cubed and 1 minus h cubed. Or you could use your favorite pair of functions that add up to 1, like how about sine and cosine? That's the third set. And I also realize you get more flexibility, you can use any cross-section whatsoever. Like how about a 13 gon, an 8 gon, and a 5 gon just for kicks? Get my one fact about 13 back into the giveaway. Of course, then I had to make these to be able to give them to you. They're the Gengzhi goblets, so I have to make them. So I needed a mold. This is from Firedrake. If you're looking for somebody to make you pretty cheaply a injection mold, check out Firedrake. And then you may want to see them. When you get your bag, you'll see them. You know, you may be dying to see them. But if you don't have your bag, it's OK. I'll give you a nice close-up view. There's a nice close-up view of the cups. And if you don't like that URL, you could just go to studioinfinity.org to see what I've been up to lately. Thanks so much.